Okay, in this video we're going to look at exponential functions, and specifically exponential functions that have a percentage increase or a percentage decrease. So before we go any further, we should be familiar and kind of review what an exponential function is. So an exponential function is a function that takes the form of this y equals a times b to the x, where this a value is the y-intercept. When it takes this form, it's going to be the y-intercept. It's also sometimes called the initial value because it's what you start with. Okay, and we'll see that in application here in a minute. And then this b value is the growth rate. Okay, that's the factor that you're multiplying by every time. So if you look at this example, the example I've provided, it's y equals 3 times 2 to the x. Well, that's because this 3 is the y-intercept. That's that initial value that we're talking about. And then 2 here is the growth rate, because we see, as we know about exponential functions, there's a multiplicative change. We're multiplying to get to the next spot in the table. Here, that value that we're multiplying by is a 2. So because of that times 2, that's where we get that growth rate from. Okay. Now, with that in mind, we're going to look at some examples where this amount that we're changing by isn't going to be an easy number. It's not just going to be doubling or tripling every time. It's going to be increasing by a percentage, and we're going to see how that looks in some examples. So let's start with this. You have $500 in credit card debt, but you are unable to pay it. Your credit card charges 15% interest per year. How much will you owe in 10 years if you make no payments? Now, for the sake of being color-coded, I'm going to keep that as red. So if we know our function takes the form of y equals a times b to the x, that a we talked about is our initial value, and that b value is our growth rate, okay? Now, for this example, let's write what the function would be. We'll worry about what would happen in 10 years once we know what our function is, okay? Now, here, our initial value is that 500. That's how much debt we start with, and that's being multiplied by our growth rate, whatever that growth rate is, to the x power. Now, here's where it's a little tricky. It's a little tricky to find that growth rate for these problems. So for this 15% right here, that's how much our value's changing by. It's increasing by 15% each time. Each year, the amount we owe is going to be 15% higher than the year before it, okay? Now, your thought might be, well, we should put a 15 here. Well, that wouldn't be accurate, because that would be taking 500 and multiplying it by 15. That wouldn't be a 15% increase. That would be a times 15 increase. So we don't want to do that. You might be saying, oh, let's use the decimal form of 15. Let's use 0.15. Well, that wouldn't work either. That would be saying that we are only going to have 15% of what we had the previous year at all. That would mean that our amount we owe is going down, and we know that's not the case. We're not paying our credit card. The amount here would be increasing. So the way we do it is this. I know that the next year I'm going to have 100% of 500, but then I'm going to have an extra 15%. In other words, we're taking 500 and multiplying it by 115%. If you remember anything about converting percentage to decimals, you know that I would take 115% and move the decimal two places to the left to get 1.15. That's how I'm getting this growth rate. I added 15% to 1 because the amount we owe is increasing, okay? So that's our function. And x is just going to be the number of times that we multiply that over and over again. So for this problem, and I'll just move over here to the right, it's going to be y equals 500, and every year we're going to multiply it by 115%, and the number of times we're going to do that is 10. And we get the 10 because in 10 years. So I could just go and do, let's see, we have 500 times 1.15 to the 10th, and I'm just going over here to my calculator. That's going to be about 2,023 dollars, roughly. Okay, let's look at another example, and I'm going to make this one disappear. In this example, it says your really nice car is currently worth $40,000. However, it depreciates, or in other words, goes down in value by 8% each year. How much will it be worth in 10 years? So we're going with 10 years again, but that initial value, the current value of the car is $40,000, and this tells you that it goes down in value by 8% each year. How much will it be worth in 10 years? So, once again, we're going y equals a times b to the x, and I'm going to beat this dead horse by saying a is that initial value, and b is that growth rate, okay? Now for this one, we're going to have y equals, that initial value is the easy thing to find, that's $40,000, and that's going to be multiplied by some growth rate to the x power, some growth rate to the x power. Now here's where we got to, once again, use some logic to figure out that growth rate. It's going down in value by 8% each year. So we know that if I want something to go down in value, I need to multiply it by a number less than 1. So we know that this growth rate right here, this value, this B value, is going to be somewhere in between 0 and 1. It's going to be some sort of decimal, okay? Now, once again, your initial thought might be, okay, 1.08, like we did last time. Last time we added our percentage to 1. Well, this would be causing it to go up in value. We don't want to multiply by 108%. That would be if it increased in value by 8%. Then you might say, okay, well, let's just do 0.08. Well, that wouldn't be accurate. That would be saying that the car only retains 8% of its value every year. That would be a huge drop in value. So what we do here is we're actually going to use 0.92. And the way we get that 0.92 is, I'll just write it over here to the side, last time where we added 1 plus our growth rate, here because we're decreasing, I'm going to do 1 minus our growth rate. Because, for example, if we lose 8% of our value, that means every year we're retaining 92% of our value. So this 0.92 is just the decimal form of 92%. So for this particular problem, we are going to do y equals 40,000 times 0.92 to the 10th power, because we're worried about 10 years later, and we'll use our function to work that out, and I'm going to come over to my calculator again. 40,000 times 0.92 to the 10th. And this means our car is going to be worth about $17,376 10 years later. Okay? To summarize from this video, we're going to make our exponential functions take this form. The initial value is easy to find. The growth rate, we have to get creative with that. If we are increasing by a certain percentage, your growth rate will be 1 plus whatever that growth rate is, like we did in our first example. If it's decreasing, we're going to do 1 minus our growth rate, like we did in our second example.